I have given the design procedure for the design of flange coupling. We will now take up a few problems and do them. Now, first problem, I have selected problem number one from the question bank. Design a cast iron protected type flange coupling to transmit 15 kilowatt. Power is 15 kilowatt. At a speed of at 900 rpm from an electric motor to a generator or compressor, the service factor may be taken as 1.35. The following permissible stresses may be used: shear stress tau for shaft, key and bolt. All three are made of same material, so the shear stress for all of them is 40 megapascal or 40 newton per mm square. Crushing stress for key as well as bolt is 80 MPa, 80 megapascal. Shear stress for cast iron, that is for flanges, it is 8 MPa, 8 MPa or 8 megapascal or 8 newton per mm square. With this data, design the shaft. So design the coupling. So first, starting design of shaft. To design the shaft, we require torque. So torque is equal to 9.55 into P divided by N into 10 to the power of 6. So many newton mm. So 9.55 into 10 to the power into 15. Divided by 900 into 10 to the power of 6 newton mm. So 9.55 into 15 divided by 900 equals 0.159 into 10 to the power of 6 newton mm. This is the average torque. Now he says take service factor as 1.35. service factor, this he could have told it as the maximum torque is 35% more than the mean torque. So this is service factor into T. The meaning is the same. You could have said increase it by 35%, 1.35 into 0.159 into 10 to the power of 6. This answer I have it here, into 1.35 equals 0.22, let us take 2148 something is there, 22 into 10 to the power of 6 newton mm. So I got T max. Now dia of shaft is 16 T max divided by pi into tau of shaft material whole to the power of 1 by 3. So 16 into 0.22 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi into 40 whole to the power of 1 by 3 into 16 divided by pi divided by 40 gives me something like this, cube root of that. cube root of answer, no, I think I, 16 into 0.22 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi divided by 40 equals cube root of this. Cube root of answer will give me 30.36 mm. I'll go to the standard table, standard diameters of the shafts. 30 after 35, after 30 there is 35. So adopt dia of shaft, dia of shaft small d equals, because it is slightly more than 30, to be on the safer side I will adopt it as 35 mm. Adopt dia of shaft d is equal to 35 mm. Here afterwards, wherever we get the small d, you have to take 35 mm only. That 30 point something, that will die, that will not be taken. Next, design of key. Design of key. Design of keys. Design of keys. W and this thing. W and T we get from the table. From the table here. For 35. There is no 35 here. After 30 it is 38. No problem. W is 12 mm. T is 8 mm, thickness is 8 mm, and L we will take as 1.5D, that is 1.5 into 35, that will be around 50 mm I think, 1.5 into 35, 52.5, 52.5 mm, you can say 55 mm, no problem, 55 mm. Next, check the keys. Check the key. For induced stresses, so tau key will be equal to 2t t max divided by dlw. So 2 into 0.22 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by d is 35, l is 55, w is 12. So that how much it gets, we get 2 into 0.22 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 35 divided by 55 divided by 12 will give me 19 point something, 19.0 something. I'll take it as 19 newton per mm square. It is safe because the permissible value is 40. I am getting less than this. Now crushing stress in the key, 4t max divided by dlt, 4 into 0.22 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 35 into 55 into t is 8. 4 into 0.22 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 35 divided by 55 divided by 8 gives me 57 point something, 57.14 newton per mm square, which is again less than this. So you have to write, because induced stresses in the key are less than the permissible values, the design is safe. design of key is safe. Why? Because key is safe because these two values, this is less than 80 and that is less than 40, so the design is safe. Next, design of flanges. Outer die of hub, 2D, that is 2 into 35, that will be 70 mm. Length of hub, 1.5D, 1.5 into 35, that will be 52.5 mm. Then this is protected type, I think. So thickness of flange will be 1.5D, 0.5D, 0.5 into 35, that is 17.5 mm. D1, pitch circle die of bolts, 3D, that is 3 into 35, that will be 105 mm. D2, that is outer die of flange, 4D, 4 into 35, that will be 140 mm. Right? Thickness of protective rim, this is protected type, I think, 0.25D, that is 0.25 into 35, that will be roughly about half of this, 9 mm, roughly it is 9 mm, it doesn't come in calculation. Now number of bolts, N will be equal to 3 because the dia is less than 40 mm, the dia of the shaft is 35 mm, which is less than 40, so number of bolts is 3. All these dimensions you have got. Now check for induced stresses in the hub and flange. So for hub, tau hub will be equal to 16 T max divided by pi into d cube into 1 minus k to the power of 4. K will be di by do, that is small d by capital D, that will be 0.5. 16 into 0.22 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi into d, that is 70 cube into 1 minus 0.5 to the power of 4. So (16)(0.22)×10⁶ divided by pi divided by 70 to the power of 3 divided by 0.9375. It is 3.5 roughly Newton per mm square. It is less than 8. 8 megapascal is given. Tau flange, shear stress induced in the flange, will be 2t divided by pi d square into tf. So 2t max it is. 2 into t max is 0.22 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi into d square, that is 70 square into tf is 17.5. So 2 into 0.22 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi divided by 70 square divided by 17.5. This gives me 1.63 Newton per mm square. Now both these values that I am getting are less than 8 megapascal or 8 Newton per mm square. So design of flange is safe. Design of flanges is safe. Is safe because those stresses are less. Next, design of bolts. Design of bolts, I have to find out the dia of the bolt. So the formula is T max, design of bolts. The formula is T max is equal to N into pi d square by 4 into tau bolt into d1 by 2. This is d1 square. So d1 will be equal to under root t max into 4 into 2 divided by n into pi into tau bolt into d1, capital D1. So T max is 0.22 into 10 raised to 6 into 4 into 2 divided by number of bolts is 3 multiplied by pi into bolt. Shear stress for bolt is also 40 into D1, that is 3 times dia of the shaft, that is I think 105 under root. So 0.22 into give me 6.66 mm. Say you can take it as 8 mm. So you have to write, therefore M8 bolts, that is metric threaded bolts of 8 mm nominal dia are to be used. So this completes the problem. One problem.